Let's get the stream set up. And any moment we can get started. And refresh this quickly and sort the audio. Check that everything is up and running. And we can check out some weird little games. Here we go. It's looking like we've got people starting to filter in. How is everyone doing today? The decision to stream this during the daytime today instead of Dondoko Island in Like a Dragon is a very last minute choice. But this game about solitaire and horses has captured my dopamine-seeking, slightly out of control today, ADHD brain. So I'm following the dopamine. We'll get back to Dondoko Island soon. And I'm having a day where I found a new thing when number go up. And I do the same thing repeatedly over and over again and number go up. And Ooh, my brain likes it. Incompetent Hero said, this UI reminds me of So You Want Those Games, Hut, etc. It's got that vibe. Let me turn that down slightly in my ears. Yeah, exactly. It gives people a chance to catch up on Yakuza. Several new games dropped today. I might start a fresh save on this so that people can, like, get the tutorial as to what's going on. But I just want to do one more race on my, like, actual save I've been playing for a bit today because, gosh, I am really getting into the rhythm of all the things. You were there. I'm sorry. It's been a long day. Okay, don't let it get you down. Oh, I lost my last race. So this... I'm going to tell you the conceit, and we'll start a new playthrough on a different profile and show you, but the gist is... I dream of being a horse racer, but have never raced a horse. This man took a chance on me, I fell off a horse and got my head stamped on by a horse and died. An angel was like, I'll send you back to Earth, but you have to achieve your greatest dream. And I'm like, my greatest dream is being a jockey, but I fucking suck at it. I'm good at solitaire though. And the angel's like, okay, I'm gonna bring you back to life and do a spell where if you're good at solitaire, the horse racing will go good. Go live your dream. And if you die, again, if you fail to become a horse jockey, I will send you to the fiery pits of hell for all eternity. So that's the concept of pocket card jockey. It's a racing game slash card game slash several things. I'm gonna show you, like, one actual race from where I'm at my save file. And then we'll, like, go to the start. Because the start is a tutorial. But I just want to throw you in the deep end as to what this is. Ooh, have we got a new... Yeah, okay. So this is my horse, which I believe is named Blingin' Kid? Yeah, this is Blingin' Kid, the three-year-old horse. They have some abilities. Their unity power goes up when they're between rival horses. Sometimes they draw cards better. And sometimes the next card you need to play kind of sparkles. Let's look at the career. You can look at the margins and the ranking and the placements. I got a few firsts. I've got a couple of tenths and thirteenths mixed in my career. You can look at the pedigree and be like, which horses led to this horse existing? I don't have any Wonder Beans, which apparently will let me level up my horse. Thimba said, I just realized my Twitch stream had captions on and they're incredibly precise for live commentary. Yes, I have a really good plugin built into OBS that not only does it transcribe what I'm saying live, but it looks back over the sentence, and if it realizes that a word it chose doesn't make sense, it will find a word that fits better, that makes more sense than the sentence, and update the titles backwards in real time. It's great. Yeah, so let's pick a race. This is a G2. This should be okay. This race won't be in your favor. Oh no. Okay, so basically, we're trying to do, I'm going to try and explain as much of this in real time as I can. I'm trying to do solitaire. It's not strictly real solitaire, but it's up or down numbers-wise. I'm looking for the A card because it's got a 3 on it, which is the best starting card realistically. It means I start at level 3, which means I start as fast as possible out of the gate. When those start cards come in, you've got to very quickly look for which one has the number 3 on it. So when the solitaire comes up, I will click a card, and then I have to either go one higher or one lower as many times as possible. I can deal out a new card if I get stuck, but I only have a limited number of cards to deal out. The closer I can get to 100% perfecting the solitaire, the better my horse is going to be doing in the race. You have to be quick. There is a time limit, the sort of meter at the bottom. So let's go. Quick, where do I start? Jack, 10... No, I've already lost. Okay, 3. Let's deal out another one. This is a bad start. 5, 6, 5. I've already broken it. Deal out another. Deal out another. This is a bad start. Queen, Jack. Probably should have gone for the king there. Gosh, I'm dealing too many out. Are any of these going to lead to anything? Ace, 2. Ace, king. That's already dealt out. I've got lots of 8s. What's useful under an 8? 8. 9, 8. Deal out a queen, which takes me to the king, which takes me to the ace. 2, 3, 4. We take the 5 that's on a stack, because it uncovers the 4, which lets me go back to the 5. 9, 8, 7, 8. Okay, let's get as many numbers visible as possible. I've only got 3 cards in the bottom right left to deal out, so I'm not hopeful for this. Ace, king, king. 4, 3, 2, 8, 9, 10. Okay, I did all but 2. My horse's power goes down a little because I didn't quite, I didn't quite do the thing. Okay, I'll have a second to breathe here while I decide my positioning. There are cards that are coming up that are over here. If I position myself correctly, I can pick up the cards on the way. They'll give me little bonuses. If I'm in this little red band, I will have harder solitaires, but potentially bigger rewards. I'm going to back out a little bit. The more I go out to this side, the faster I will go, but the more I'll use up my horse's pace. I should probably move my webcam so that the horse pace is a bit more visible. I'm trying to not like run out of energy before the end of the race. So what I realistically want to do is stay about where I am, lined up with the horseshoes, maybe go back a little bit so that I get a slightly easier solitaire for this one because I need to get a win. God, this game's really addictive. I was going to stream more Infinite Wealth tonight, and this is the thing that made me go, I'm gonna stream stuff from the Direct tonight. Because this game is really, it's hitting all my ADHD buttons. On a day when my ADHD has been a little bit hard to wrangle anyway. Right, let's go. Let's go. Jack, queen, Jack, queen, deal out a new card. Ace, that's already, dud. 2. King, 5, 4, 5, 4, 5, 6, 7, 6, 7, 8, 7, 8, 9, 8, 9. This is better. 8, 9, 10, 9. That's what I'm looking for. That's how you do it. Ace, king. I'm looking for very specific things to get here. 2, 3. Oh, I could have done the ace there. Okay. I need the 4. I really need a king or a 2, and I've got very few cards to deal out. Okay, 2. Okay, we completed a solitaire. That is really good for us. Completing that fills up our horse's happiness, keeps us going real good. Yeah, I'm really digging this game. It is catchy as heck. Okay, I'm going relatively fast paced. If I go way higher up, this is a boost that I can use in the final race. It'll knock other horses out of the way. It's gonna cost us a chunk of energy. But I think it's worth it. Let's take a risk. I'm still getting my head around the strategy of this. Horse is happy if you can play solitaire is such a goofy concept, right? Yeah, I'm still getting my head around the positioning screen. It's, if you're on the red, like the red, yellow and white banding is how difficult of a solitaire you're gonna have. The up and down positioning is how fast you're gonna go, but also which items you're gonna get for doing so. It sort of comes together more. We'll do this race, and then I'll boot up a fresh save, and we'll do it from the start so you can see it explained, like, bit by bit, as opposed to what I've done here, which is throw you in the depths of... it's not showing me what... 4, 5... It's not highlighting the ones that are available to me this time. That's a bonus that my horse only sometimes gets. I have to actually spot things this time. Jack. No. 3, I have a 2, into an ace, into a king, ace, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, and come on, queen, into king, into queen, into, king, deal out a queen, into a jack, into a 10, into a 9, 5 into a 4 gets us the boost card. We picked it up in the race, but I had to get it from the solitaire to actually be able to use it. Yeah, if I do the tutorial in a minute, it will pause and you can take some of this in. But this is the chaos I wanted to introduce you to. Yeah, this is Game Freak indeed. This is the Pokemon people. The Pokemon people make weird games when they're not making Pokemon, and I kind of love it. Okay, right, where am I at right now? We're going into the final turn. I want to stay where I'm at difficulty-wise, I think. Yeah, what was the one they did on the 3DS? Tembo the Badass Elephant? I think it was called, that was a side-scrolling sort of platformy game that was really good. Right, if this feels very 3DS Pokemon, specifically like X and Y with Mega Evolution aesthetic in some of its animations. Okay, now we're in a real-time race. I have a limited number of times I can sort of use my riding crop. I'm trying to get to the front of the pack. I do have a boost because I picked up that boost card and I managed to successfully get it in the solitaire, which I could have used to break through the pack had I been stuck behind other horses. And there we go, we hit first place. Tembo was on multiple things, I think. I think it was on Wii U. I know it was on something Nintendo. I know it came to other stuff because it's not Pokemon, so the Game Freak can just bring it to a lot of things. There you go. This is what I'm, like, building to. Oh, I won a little trophy! What did I win a trophy for? Oh, I won a silver trophy in this year's competitive season. I love the default horse names. The horse names are ridiculous. So I gained some experience and some skill, and I leveled up my horse. I now have a D-class horse. I will get back to the select a mission screen, and we'll do the tutorial, because that might help make this make a little more sense. We got some coins, we can spend them on stuff. Okay. Okay, we won entry into the Oberon Cup, it's a G1 event. I've yet to win a G1 event. It's a long one, 3,000 meters. Keep a close eye on Blingin' Kid's stamina. Okay, we need to be very conservative on that one. But this is a good chance for me to re-get the tutorial into my head before I do a difficult race, so... We'll do the tutorial and then we'll hop back to this save and try and win that G1 class race. This is the NPC who sells us stuff between races. It's got a very WarioWare aesthetic to the character designs, right? Tembo was published by Sega. Cool. Okay. So yeah, there's kind of a branching difficulty thing that's going on. But for now, we are gonna exit that and then re-enter on a different profile so I can show you the tutorial. We'll go through the little bit of plot. And hopefully going through this from the start, it's going to take a minute, but hopefully it'll make some of this make more sense. And it's probably good for me because I am ever so slightly flailing. I'm just about getting it, I think. Incompetent Hero says, if you said this was still Yakuza, I would believe it. Honestly, right? The Pocket Card Jockey Ride On. I can see why this game did really well on Apple Arcade. This seems like a very addictive phone game. Choose your gender, blue or pink. It doesn't gender you, it doesn't go he or she. They've gone long hair is pink, but they do use they them for your character regardless. Name the main character. Chat, we're starting this playthrough to show this for you, chat. What do we want to name our jockey? Give me some jockey names. Oh, Kasuga. I was about to say Ichiban. Ichiban or Kasuga would maybe be a good one. You know what? I'm not going to go Kasuga, but I'm going to go Ichiban. A group of toilets. You're going to have to wait for the Like a Dragon stream for us to get the toilet chat back. This is Ichiban. This is Ichiban the jockey, who's going to be the greatest jockey in the world. This is Ichiban. As you could maybe tell by the clothes, they are a jockey. They're not very good at it, but boy do they have heart and big dreams too. Sounds like Ichiban to me. Oh look, here comes a trainer. A trainer is someone who raises horses lent to them by owners so they can win races. Excuse me, sir, I'd really like to enter the derby. Please let me ride an amazing horse. Oh, you kidder. If I actually had a horse like that, my life would be much easier. Well, I'll see you around. No, come on, you gotta let me have something I can ride. Just give me one that runs straight. Sure, would you want to jump on for a bit of training? Yeah, you won't have a chance of getting into the derby if you can't even train. Okay, I'll do the best training ever. Yeah. So we're going to learn how to ride a horse. Thimba says, by choosing the name Ichiban, now you can't screw this up. And you want to know why? Sure, why? Okay. Go. Go, horse. And that was how Ichiban died. Okay, that was how Ichiban died. Ichiban needs a number one, exactly. Yeah, Ichiban's dead. GG, good game. Hey, you, get up. Kaboom. Hello again. Where are we? Why is it so dark? Oh, you're going to die soon. Not making much sense. Were you kicked in the head by a horse or something? Oh wait, that's right. That horse... Sir, that horse is the worst. It doesn't do anything I tell it to. You were kicked by that horse, and now you are dying. Wait, are you serious right now? Very. I don't want to die. I want to go in the derby. You can't even train properly, and you're talking about the derby. Look. Would you stop calling me sir? I'm an angel. Oh, the things you say are almost as weird as the mysterious ring over your head. I just want to mention that whatever god you represent, I totally believed in them while I was alive, and...
Shall I bring you back to life?
Can you do that?
an angel, I can do pretty much what I want. Also, I'm in a good mood since I won big at the track. I'm a horse racing fan, you see. I have one condition, though. If I bring you back to life, you must make your dream come true.
Great deal. Great deal. I love this deal.
If you fail, I'm sending you straight to heck when you die. Sound good?
But, sorry, hang on. Did you just say I'll go to heck, like with a capital H?
Oh yes, it's pretty gnarly down there, just so you know. Fire, brimstone, eternal damnation, faucets leak, stuff smells weird. Honestly, it's the pits.
Okay, so my dream is to cook mac and cheese, you know, the kind from a box. Thing is, I don't have a pot. There's this old hubcap cover I saw by the side of the road that would work, but then I need milk.
I thought your dream was to win at the derby.
That's more like a fantasy. I mean, it's just not realistic considering how bad I am with horses. The dialogue in this is wonderful. These characters are very charming.
Better improve fast then, because if you don't win the derby while you're alive, heck.
Riding horses is really hard. Have you tried it?
Oh, you're hopeless. Do you have anything that you do like?
I like omelets.
It's not what I meant. I'm asking if you have interests, hobbies, anything you're even remotely good at.
Lately, I've been playing so much solitaire on my Switch that my fingers are going numb.
If you've got that much free time, why don't you practice riding horses?
I do that too, honest.
Okay, well, I've got an idea. I'm going to make you ride a horse as well as you play solitaire.
Yeah, you get the gist. We're going to play solitaire, and that's going to make the horse go good. Back to life we come. I'm all right. Hi, Mr. Angel. Thank you for bringing me back to life and all. Understandably, he's a little confused. Yeah, I can still train. I'll give it a shot. So yeah, we'll explain the mechanics a little more one by one. This is a horse that teaches us how to play solitaire. Horse, of course. Nice to meet you. Sure. What are the rules of solitaire? You want to clear as much of this tableau away as possible. You pick a card from the bottom row. Let's pick a card. Let's pick a six. Okay, we're doing eight, because it's a tutorial, then a seven, then a six, then a five, then a... No, a four or a six. Look at that, you understand how solitaire works here. Once there's no cards, you've got the deck in the bottom right. You flip it, it turns over a card. It's a king, that's good, we can continue going. But... Anytime you can't play anything and you have to take another card from the bottom, right now there's no limit, but eventually there will be a limit and we'll have to try really hard to not use up all our cards. That's where the challenge comes in. Oh, I need an ace or a queen. I went past an ace there because I was not paying proper attention. How much was this? I don't know. Let me see if I can find out how much it is. Pocket card jockey switch. 13 pounds. So, you know, it's in that middle range of indie game prices. But honestly, so far... I can see myself losing so much fucking time to this game. Yeah. What do you say you ride one of my horses for a debut race? Yeah, hooray! So, first partner. He's gonna let us borrow first partner to do a couple of races. Yeah, I think it's a reasonable price for this. The fact that it's... I'm hooked on it enough that I was like, I need to change what my stream is for tonight. Okay, so we're just going to focus on this one big debut race. During races, you have to charge your horse's energy, which we'll explain how to do that in a minute. We're going to have energy left for the home stretch. We got this. We can follow this. Is one of the competitors in this race called Chicken Turd? Yeah, so this is your little starting grid. You do a solitaire here to reveal one of the start cards, and that's how quick things are going to start. Just have to clear a column from the tableau. Then you grab the card, and whatever level that card is, that's how quick you'll sort of go out the gate. Chicken third, which somehow makes sense, less sense. Kinda, yeah. So yeah, during this bit, it's just sort of animated, it's automated. It's the solitaire, the positioning where you go, and the real-time bit at the end, basically. So this should be a very easy solitaire, because we got a very slow start to the race. We only got a level one start, so it's going to give us a very easy solitaire. Yeah, so if you see that 28 in the bottom right on that deck, that's how many times we can turn over a fresh card if we get stuck. Does anything change how fast that top number increases? Yes, we'll get to that in a second. So, Unity Power is that thing in the bottom left. We'll get there in a second as well. 8, 7, 8, 7, 8, 9, 10, 9, 10, jack, queen, king, 3, 4, 5, 4, 3, 2. Let's get a something that we can, oh, I could have worked with that 10. I need to not, when you get stuck in a rut like this, you have to just not stress and not skip past workable cards just because you're like, ah, oh, quick, go, show me something that fits. 8, 7, 6, 5. Aha! Now I can play the jack. There we go. So, we did well at solitaire. Number in the bottom left goes up. Okay. So you'll play a few rounds of solitaire. The difficulty changes depending on where you're positioned on the track. Difficulty can be good, though. Harder solitaire charges more energy. Energy is that stuff in the bottom left. The higher the number is, the faster your horse will run on the home stretch. For now, just try to remember that charging energy is really, really important. So yeah, that number at the top is going to be how fast you run in, like, the real-time bit at the end. But we'll get back to those in a second. This may seem like a strange complaint or observation, but Game Freak seems to love using that really cheap MIDI guitar sound. Yeah, they found a sound that sounds like them and they stuck with it. Okay. So yeah, if we, during the repositioning, if we come reposition over here, the solitaire will get harder because we're moving into a stronger color of solitaire. It uses up some of our power to move around, so don't move around more than you need to. And any of it that we don't use, like moving around, gets sent to that number at the top. So do good at solitaire, you build up number in the bottom, you use it to move around, and any you don't use up goes up to the top. And that's how you sort of build up your speed for the end. Does that make sense? Do good solitaire, points go down to the bottom left. You use the points in the bottom left to move. Any you don't use moving, go to your speed at the end of the race. I was expecting each race to be a lot shorter or simpler. There's a decent length to these rounds. Yeah, yeah, you're playing like multiple games of solitaire in the middle of a horse race. 8, 7, 8, 7, 6. Seven, eight, nine, ten, two, three, six, five, ten, no. What you don't want to do is what I've done, where lots of the things that are visible on the row are all the same, and you've sort of artificially limited how many playable directions you can go. Ace, king, ace, king, ace, no, jack, 10, 9, 8, 3, let's go 5, 6, 7, 6, deck, ooh, queen, king, can't get anything else, 10, 9, 8, 9, 2, 3, 4, queen, jack, queen, 2, 1, we didn't quite complete the row. Any cards that are left over that you don't successfully get out of the solitaire will lower your power in the bottom left. So you don't want to pick a solitaire that you're not confident you can succeed in, necessarily. Then you've got the top left, which is like how fast you are running around the course. A tired horse is slow in the home stretch. Stamina gradually decreases as a race goes on. You'll burn through it extra fast if you're going fast. You want to have like 40 stamina left going into the home stretch. If you want to conserve stamina, head to the inside of the track. So if we move over to here, we will get more stamina. We won't be in a good position to get like items and stuff. But we will have more stamina and be less likely to like run out of pace right at the last minute. So we go into the home stretch. So you basically just go up and down to avoid bumping into any other horses. You have the whip. If you use it too often, your horse will slow down rather than speed up. You can also slow down in a worst case scenario. If you get like boxed in by other horses, it might be best to slow down, move to the side, and then speed up. And then you've got your current placement in the race. So let's go like this. Where's there a good opening? We'll sort of head up this way, do this to sort of sprint and speed up. Sometimes you get boost cards. You have a little track at the top to see where you are in the pack. And there we go, first place. Does this make a little more sense now that I have shown, at the very least, the basic tutorial? Rather than trying to explain it in real time in a kind of hectic race. Because there is more tutorial and we can do more tutorial, but I feel like this gets the gist of it across. Focus on me play says, I just got here, I missed the tutorial. We play solitaire good, we race horses, we win. I'll try and talk through it again as we do it in real time. But yeah, if the folks who were here for the tutorial feel like that was enough tutorial, I might jump back into doing some non-tutorial races some more and see if I can win that big, the big race. Yeah, fuck it, I'm going for it. I'm not that far in. I played maybe a couple of hours and started going, oh, I see what the deal is. Jump me back in. I'm ready for the big race. Focus on me play. The Pyoro absolutely got everything right. Everything Pyoro said was accurate as ever. Always bet on Pyoro. Cass, yeah, this game is... It's real easy to get real hooked on this. It's got its claws in me already. We'll do a bit of Penny's Big Breakout in a bit, but... Gosh, I am so into... time pressure! Solitaire, now! Okay. We are up against... Premium Member, Quick Trick, Gold Screen, Best Line, Beauty Doll, Blue Lapis... Ask her today. What's some good names in here? There we go. Can I win a G1 race? Let's find out. Also, there's PvP in this. There's PvP multiplayer online. Okay, so I'm going to do a quick bit of solitaire to see how quick I come out of the starting grid. I want to get the A card, ideally. Yeah. Because that's a level 3, that'll mean I can get a really quick start. The collector's edition of Gundam Breaker 4 comes with a Gunpla model kit. Contemplating whether to buy it, it's only available in America at the moment. How much is it in America? And do I know anyone American who can help me access it? 8, 7, new card, 3, 4, 5, 4, 3, 2, new card, Jack, 10, Jack, 10, 9, 8, 9, fresh card. Right. King, ace, 2, 3, 2, fresh card, 5, 6, that's it. Jack, 10, 9, fresh card, 5, 6, queen, let's go for the king here, 10, jack, queen, king, ace, 7, 8, we've got 8 cards left. We're pretty close to the end of here. Come on, I need to be careful with these cards. I've always got more time than I think. I don't need to rush as much as I am rushing. Okay, and sometimes I can just, let's see, 2, 7. Okay, I took a little bit of negative. I had 1 card left, but that wasn't bad. $90. What's the Gunpla it comes with? I'm curious now. Okay, so what do I want to do? I'm not too worried about these horseshoe cards, so I'm not going to go too far on the outside lane. I'm going to stay sort of average inside lane. I'm going to drop down to a level 2 solitaire. Oh, no, they pushed me up. Okay, other horses can sort of get in the way of where you're trying to get to, so I am stuck doing a fast pace now, which I didn't really want to be doing. I should have tried going forward a bit to get into the gap. But at least I'm on a medium difficulty gun barrel strike Gundam. I will give that a look in a minute. Okay, king, queen, that's it. That was a bad starting spot. 10, 7, ace, 2, let's go, 3, 4, 5, 4, 5, 6, jack, 10, jack, 10, jack, queen, king, ace, 2, ace, 8, no, I could have gone further, 8, 9, 2 can go to a 3, to a 2, what have I got? 7, 6, 7, 6, 5, 6, 7. Come on. 7 cards. We can get the queen. The jack to the 10 to the 9. Cool. Passed it. Strike recolor. It's some fancy stuff. It's on Warrior64's Twitter. I will have a look as soon as... Actually, let's have a look. Let me check Warrior64 quickly. Right, I'm gonna quick look at this Gundam that comes with the Gundam game. It'll be somewhere here. I'm scrolling looking for it. I'm not seeing the oh, there it is. Oh, that's a trans pride. That's a trans flag recolored Gundam. That's some really good pinks and whites and blues. Oh, I'm very tempted. On the subject of Gundam/Gunpla, are the shows where they're based on toys worth watching? I finished the original timeline stuff and don't know where to go from there. There was one recently that is lesbians, and that's worth watching. I forget what it's called. Right, where am I trying to get to? My pace is good. I can probably afford to speed up a bit. My power's good. You know what? Let's try and get a little forward here. Let's try and get to here. Witch from Mercury, yes. Gundam the Witch from Mercury is lesbians and it's good. Sorry, my brain was too solitaired up to remember words. Okay, here we go. Three rounds left. Oh god, this is a long race. Okay, it's good I'm still... Given how long this race is, I need to stick on this inside track as long as I can. King, Queen, fresh card. Come on. 8, 9, 10, nothing fresh. Oh, this is a really bad start. We don't have King, so we go 3, 2, 2, the ace to the King. 8, 7 to the 6, 5, 6, 5, 4, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 4, 2. We can get the ace. 9. There's 9 gets us to 10. Gets us to the Jack. King gets us ace, 2. Nothing else. King. Jack gets us the heart at least. This is a long race, we need to play it out. 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4. We have one card, are you? No, you're not gonna match. That's fine, we can live with that. I think it's the horse racing aspect, but it reminds me of an N64 game I saw someone play for over 90 hours. I told myself I wouldn't get more switched up, but this game makes it very difficult to stick to that. It's very appealing. Yeah, I'm trying to stick on the inside lane away from all the big orange and yellow sort of zigzags, because I need to keep my pace because there's a very long race and I need to not lose my energy before the end. I'm reasonably positioned in the pack. I'm not too worried about these horseshoes, but if I see a boost, I'll probably come up here and like run a little faster for like one section. I'm probably going to leave the difficulty where it's at for now. Let's just do this. Okay. We're pacing this well. We have a couple of these little horseshoe cards that'll help us get upgrades and stuff. Ooh, peak time. Sometimes everything goes very fast and you just have to go. 7, 6, 7, 8, 9, 8. Right, 3, nothing to go with that. Ace, king, ace, king, ace, king. Yeah, this is rapid fire. Just go. Don't think too much, just go. 3, 4, Jack gets a 10. King, nothing. 3, 4, 7, 8, 9, 8, 7, 6, 10, nothing. 5, nothing. Queen, nothing. 9, 10, Jack, 10. Queen gets us nothing. 5 gets us nothing. 2 gets us nothing. 6, nothing. Jack, nothing. Cornered myself here, haven't I? 5 gets me the 4, doesn't get me anything else. That's a bit of lost power, that's unideal. Oh, the Strike Gundam that comes with Breaker is based on the entry grade Strike Gundam. Oh, that's a shame because the colors are great on it. Right, my average pace is good. I need more power. I would ideally like to do a harder... Try and do a harder solitaire on this one. Yeah, no, I'm kind of stuck in the pack here. Let's go for it. Yeah, the entry grade one is like, I think that's the grade that I did a Gundam at a convention once and it took like 15 minutes. I think that was entry grade. It's the, we use this to tutorial people who've never Gundamed on making a Gundam in like a setting where we need fast turnover of people coming in and out of the event. Yeah. I did it because I was just looking for something to do with the time, but it was like, oh yeah, no, this is not what I usually get out of doing Gundams. Let's go queen, new king, new queen to king, queen. Three gets us nothing. Seven. Oh, seven could have got us. Okay, we still get six. Five. Four, three, four, three, four, eight, nine, ten, jack, seven, six, five, four, goes to the jacks, gets anything. Yeah, I'm cornering myself again. Okay, we get the ace, gets us two, gets us ace, gets us two. I bought my 7-year-old nephew an entry grade for Christmas to introduce him to Gundam building. Entry grade. Oh god, I have to talk about entry grade. I have the annoyance with entry grade Gundams, and I forgot I wanted to talk about this. Entry grade Gundams. You know the plastic sheets that all the parts come on Gundam model kits, and you realistically need to have a pair of like clippers to like clip the excess off when you push it off the plastic. Entry grade kits, you push them out of the plastic and there is zero needs to be clipped excess. Why are all Gundam kits not built like this, that you can just pop them out with your fingers and there's no bit you have to clip off? What? Big Gundam has that tech and doesn't let us enthusiast hobby level Gundam builders have it. Oh. Anyway, that's... I know, I say that as someone where I'm like, I enjoy meticulously taking the thing. But it's the principle of the thing. I was permitted once to taste the glory of an didn't require clipping Gundam kit, and I'm like, oh, you're just putting me through this, huh? Yeah. I know. Look, I know there's legitimate reasons for not doing it, but also... I want to be a little sulky baby and go, you're holding all the good Gundam tech from us. Okay, right, where am I? I'm going to stay where I'm at in the pack. I think this is the best shot. Right, we're going into the final turn. I think we still have one solitaire left. Oh, I've been pushed into the easy lane. Oh, I know you can push them out, but the difference is... Those entry-level kits, it's like, yeah, I would still use the clippers, but I'm not having to, like, I put two parts together and go, why aren't they sitting together? Oh god, I missed a bit that I need to smooth. Chew! Right, I didn't get a boost, so I'm gonna have to just work through the pack as best I can. I think I've got an opening. Okay. Okay, I'm kind of trapped in the pack. Ugh. I needed a boost. I needed to grab a boost somewhere there. That's entirely on me. Where did I come? Fifth. Okay, let's give it one more go. I want to win a G1 race today. I'm still, like, the G1 races are where I'm starting to hit my skill ceiling. But I'll get there. Oh, I forgot I could have gone to the shop. That probably would have helped. But I gained some experience. I leveled up. I have a slightly better horse now. I have a C-grade horse. When playing solitaire, touching unplayable car. Oh, didn't catch that. Okay, I got 7 coins from the Oberon Cup. Don't feel sad about it. The Starkeeper stakes are coming up. And if we win the place well, we can go to the All-Star Cup. Okay. cool. We'll just get right back on the horse and keep going. Okay, there's a G- if we win this, we can still do a G1 race. Oh, I missed my opportunity to go to the shop. That's on me. Oh, it's almost my horse's 4th birthday. My horse is going to be 4 years old soon. The final year of their racing prime is coming up. Place in the top 4 for bonus coins. Okay. I need to remember to pay attention to what, like, reward bonus cards are coming up. Okay. Where's the 3? It's on the R. A. 2, 3. That's a level 3. Okay, we'll start at level 3. These game horses are so cute. I love these adorable little stubby friends. Okay. It's a reasonably lengthy race, this one. Oh, incompetent hero, have an acceptable dentist visit. I hope it is as untraumatic as a dentist can be. Okay. We're coming around the first corner. Okay, there's a level 3. We're gonna go 10, Joker, Queen, King, Ace, King, Ace, 7, we can go, 8, 9, 8, 9, nothing for Ace, 7, 6, 5, 6, 2, onto the 3, might as well, 3 onto the 4, 5, 6, that's it. Queen, King, Queen, Jack. 3, 2, 3, 4, 9, 8, 7, 6, Jack's not gonna go out, Queen, no, 5, 4, yeah, that's gonna have to do, 10, 9, 10, Jack, 10, 8 can go out, 3 down on the horse energy, but that's fine, we're still in green. You have to, do you not have to alternate between red and black cards? No, you don't. At least where I'm at in the game currently. I don't know if that's going to be introduced at some point. Right now, it doesn't matter whether it's red or black. And that really threw me at first. Okay, I want to be... Let's say... I want to move to, like, here. Let's try and get into that spot. Can I get ahead of... that horse and in to the gap. Okay, we're coming up on the next, like solitaire, right. The medium one, let's go. King, Queen, King, Queen, Jack, Queen, Jack, N, 9, 5, 4, 3, 2, Ace, King. 7, what do I want? 7, 8, 7, 8, 9. King, Queen. Jack, that's at least a little combo. 5, 4, 3, 4, 3, 2, 3, 4. Eight, nine, ten. Jack. 5, 6, 5, 6. Full solitaire. Perfect. Big bonuses. Big happy horse bonus. Okay, I want to be positioned for this boost. So I want to be like... here. If I can get that boost card, that's going to really, really hecking help. Yes. I have to get it out of the solitaire still, because it'll get dealt into the solitaire. But if I can get it from the solitaire, that's going to be a really big advantage in the final straight. Okay, oh, what am I doing? Queen, Jack, 7, oh, 6, 5, 4, Queen, King, Ace, 2, Ace, 2, Ace, 2, 3, 4, 3, that was a pretty good one. Jack, no, 8. 7, 8, 9, oh, that one could have kept going and I tapped the thing instinctively, probably screwed myself over pretty badly there, 8, 9, 7, 6, 7, 6, 10, oh, I at least got the 9, 10, Jack, I got the boost. That's really what I needed to get out of this. Okay. Okay, how am I doing pace-wise? We are... oh, it's multiple laps. Okay, I've got to keep my pace reasonable. They're up there, that's fine. Don't... ooh, yeah, let's stay roughly where we are. Come on, I just want to win one G1 rank race today. Two rounds left. Okay, break time. I gotta go fast. 5, 6. Oh, what have I got? 9, 8. 5, 6. Queen, Jack. 8. King. 10. Ace. 2, 3, 4, 5. Jack, no, 10, 3, 2, 3, 2, 7, 8, 7, 8, 9, 10, Jack, 10, 9, Queen, King, Queen, King, Ace, King. 3, 4. Ace. 2, 6, 7, 6. Ace. No. Okay. Frame into focus. Have a good look. Oh, my pace is running. Oh, my energy is running real low. I need to get into this inside lane if I'm gonna avoid collapsing at the last straight. Oh, I have so little energy left. For the final straightaway. Ooh! I realistically need like 40 going into that final straightaway, is what I've been told. I'm not under that bar yet, but ouch, this is... Oh yeah, I'm gonna run out of energy before this race is over. I was not quite conservative enough with my energy. Oh god. Ace, king. 4, 3, 7, 6, 7, 8, 7, 8, 9, 10, 9, 10, 9, 10, jack, queen, jack, queen, jack, 9, 8, 2, 3. Two, ace, king, ace, two, ace, two, three, four, five, six. Oh, come on, six, five. Oh, okay. I cleared the thing, so I got some of my heart back, but... I need to stay on the inside. I need to stay super slow pace. I don't know if this is even doable with 19 energy to use. Team. They recommend usually having 40 going into the final corner. Okay, how far back in the pack am I? I'm gonna use that boost. It's my only real chance is to get out of ahead of the pack now and hope I can keep that lead going before I run out of energy and slow down. Oh, there we go. Okay, I got first. Okay. Can I get... This is going to entitle me to a G1 race. Can I get first on the G1? Or at least can I podium on the G1? I won a medal in this competitive season. Hurrah. Actually got a trophy. Objective was top 4, we got it. Ooh. Okay, got 67 coins. We're gonna take on the All-Star Cup. Come on. Okay, I can do it. I can do this. Ooh, the shop's gonna be open. Oh, that's gonna really help. Oh, thank you for having the shop open just before the G1. Traveling salesperson. Ooh. Happy horses. What can I buy? Oh. Guide goggles. Let's make sure that I can see what cards connect to which cards. Dash crop. What does dash crop do? Make the starting gate a breeze? Sure. Quick gloves? Sure, we'll grab those. Hundred coins, yeah. Give me a restock. Let me get extra stuff. Let me get a stamina carrot. Yeah, that'll do. Can I win one little championship? before my horse's fourth birthday. Your horse loves this distance. It's a great chance to take a trophy home. Okay. Okay, this is a good distance for my horse. That's good to know. Race objective placed in the top 12. Okay, that's fine. Crowns appear on the top three horses with the most energy. They're likely to be the fastest horses in the home stretch. Oh, didn't know that's what the crowns were signifying. Okay, there's a three. I see what that does. I've just noticed there's lyrics to whatever horse song is happening behind this horse race. Okay, right, where do we start? 10, 9, 10, jack, 10, go, queen, jack, nothing, 7, 8, 7, 6, king, ace, 2, 3, 4, 5, 4, 3, 2, nothing, 6, 5, 6, 5, 6. Am I double dealing? Oh, am I double dealing by not being careful with how long I spend with the deck button down? Oh, I'm fucking myself over. That's probably not helping. 10, jack, queen, king. Oh, yeah, I just dealt over like three cards. Is there a way that I can like press a button rather than use the analog stick? Because fuck. 4, 3, 2, 3, 2, ace. Oh! Yeah, I've been fucking myself over. I've been dealing too many cards out because I'm not quick enough at letting go of the analog stick. Oops. Okay, well, we're gonna work with it. We're gonna work with it. I want to be in the rank 2. I don't see any upcoming cards that I desperately need, so I'm gonna... This is perfect time to be on the inside lane, just gaining power. Oh, is it because I used the quick draw gloves? Oh, I actively don't want that power up. It draws cards quicker. But it means I'm having to take my finger off the analog stick quicker. That's why it wasn't doing it in every race. The quick draw... Oh, I don't want the quick draw gloves. Okay, I know that now. I hadn't understood what was occurring. Okay, ace... King, nothing. 3, 4, 3, 7, 6, 5, 5, 6, 15, jack. Queen, jack. 10. Jack, queen, king, 2, 3, 7, 8, 9, 8, 9, 8, 2, 3, 2, 4, 5, 4, 8, 7. Coordination is not making the single draws easy to do. 2, ace. I don't have the coordination for that. 10. Yeah, I don't have the coordination to manually deal one out at a time. It looks like it's skipping over cards you can't do anything with. It's actually... it's not actually multi-pulling. Oh, is that what's happening? Well, I thought I was single-pulling because... maybe I'm wrong. I need to reread the description of those gloves. Okay, do we have any... We don't have any boosts coming up yet. Honestly, I kind of just want to get backwards a little bit. I want to get into the slightly easier puzzle territory. Okay, thanks for looking, chat. In the middle of playing, it's hard to... It's hard to double-check these things when there's a timer going and I'm trying to do the actual race gameplay. Jack, Queen. Jack. Four. Yeah, because it didn't skip over that four and I couldn't do anything with the four, so... Ace. I think it is just... Light tap. Maybe I'm wrong. Seven. Six. Queen. Jack. Ten. Nine. Ten. Nine. Four. Three. Four. Three. Four. Five. Six. Seven. Six. Two, give me two. There's no twos out. Let's get the queen out of the way. Seven. Eight. Nine. Five, six. All right. Eight. Three. Two. Ace. No, the card draws are manual when I have no other options. Okay, one card I couldn't do, that's fine. I'm right near the back of the pack, I should really do something. Where am I right now? What I want to do is move, like, here. And then to, like, here. If I can successfully do that. No, I'm just right in the back of the pack. Oh, no, I did get around the side. Okay. Okay. Right. Let's do this. Let's do this. King, ace, king, right, queen, jack, ace, two, three, four, three, four, five, six, seven, six, seven, eight, nine, 8, 9, 10, 9, oh, I could have done the 7, that was on me, 8, 7, back, 3, 2, 3, 4, 5, ace or queen, yeah, queen. Have a good night, Artisynth, rest well. Okay, I'm in a better position on the grid this time. We're going into the final turn. There's no boosts coming, so what I want is to go onto the outside so I can be not too trapped in by other horses, if I can help it. This is the place to use my super fast burst. come on. Ah, come on. Still second. That's the best I've done in a G1 race. I'll take second. I almost had first place. I hit the podium. Okay. Okay. You know what? I'm pretty happy with that. I think we can leave Lucky Pocket Card Jockey here for now. I think we could do like an hour and a half or so of showing off some Penny's Big Time Breakout, which is the game made by the people that made Sonic Mania before Sega had a falling out with them and they went and made their own thing. Yeah, Penny's Big Breakaway came out surprisingly today. And I have that downloaded ready for us to have a look at as well. Let me just get back to the selecting races screen. He's going into his fourth year. He's growing up a little more. It's his fourth birthday. Okay. And now get to be Big Grown-Up Horse. Sprinting Titan is a new horse available to me, but nah, I'm using Blingin' Kid. We're gonna leave it here for now, but let's take a look at Penny's Big Breakaway. Let me change the game title on Twitch. So we're on Penny's Big Breakaway. There it is, and I'll update it over there. Then were some cute horsies. Echo says, I still remain completely perplexed by the solitaire and therefore I'm completely incapable of playing this. Them's be some cute horsies though. I mean, all you need to know is if a 2 is at the bottom, you go one higher or one lower, a 1 or a 3, and you just keep going, that's a number that's near that number. Go, 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 go. Different locations, Laura. Different locations for what? I'm tired. My brain is fried. This is Penny's Big Breakaway. Did I remember to switch profiles? No, I didn't, because it's not prompting me to do 1,000 Eulas. Oh, different. Okay, yes, the Switch accounts for Japan, New Zealand, etc. Look, sometimes the store I know where I can go and buy a game, you know, before it's supposed to be on sale, don't get the game early. And then the earliest way for me to play a game is to pretend I'm in New Zealand. I mean, sorry, go on a holiday to New Zealand and pick up the game and then come back. Right. There's so many fucking Eulas to play this game. So give us a second. I'll do like the opening of this, and then I might jump over to my own save. But it give you a sense of what the deal with this is. This is 3D sort of platform adventure game by the Sonic Mania people. It's got a great aesthetic and style to it. Its energy is wonderful. Yeah, the number of Eulas is not ideal, but game's fucking good though. I mean, I have family in New Zealand. Oh, save select. I could just pick a different... How do I swap saves once I... Okay, I could have just used my own save. Mr. L, having read a chunk of them, probably not much. This is Penny. Penny would like to audition to be in the big talent show in front of the king. With her talent, which is yo-yo. Today is the big day of the auditions. The queues are real long. She's gonna do her best to sneak in and get to show the king her cool yo-yo powers. Right, the exaggerated animation's lovely, right? So here we go. There's a bunch of coins. I've yet to work out exactly what the coins are used for. Your yo-yo can be used as a weapon for attacking things. You can either use a button to do it, or you can aim the analog stick to sort of aim. the aim where you're going to shoot. You can sort of, well, we'll unlock the majority of our moveset in a minute. For now, we're hitting things with a yo-yo, and that's about it. We're just going to run around and collect some little coins. Everyone's so excited for the big talent show. Everyone's getting ready. Everyone's building the sets and stuff. But along the way there, ooh, what do we spy coincidentally, conveniently? A magic yo-yo spirit or extension or some kind of magical power-up for the yo-yo. The yo-yo is alive and is a pet now, I guess. And can do all sorts of cool tricks. Ooh, a cosmic string. How curious. Perhaps it will serve you well in your audition. Don't delay. Getting into Emperor Eddie's palace may not be so easy. Yeah, we're going to skip the queue and sneak into the palace. Just break in. Because we now have cool powers. We can use our yo-yo sort of like a little car. Ride it around. We can swing around in midair. We can do a dash. And sort of hit things that way. There's a little targeting reticle, which is appreciated. Got a little double jump in the air. Getting to like swing into the air with that with the yo-yo is never not satisfying. Sometimes you can go real zoomy down a hill. Wait, how do I? Sorry. I'm still new to this. I gotta remember how I do the. I think it's. Is it you stand still and hold the thing? Ah, yes. You build up boost for a second, and then haha, up we go. Big boost. Yes, this is where we learn. Hey, you can do a little yo-yo zoom, or you can do a dash through the air. Yo-yo spin dash! Exactly! Oh, wait! There's something up with that jump. Where I've fallen off this wire several times and I don't know what's up with this one wire not working great. It's not great that it's the first wire in the game and it doesn't function exactly perfectly, but yeah, now we can swing through the air! I think you land back on the ground and it removes the yo-yo. Yeah, but I don't know what I'm supposed to do to not have that happen. Oh, yeah, so we snuck to the front of the queue. The lack of music is weird. There is music. It's just quiet. But there'll be more music when we get into the actual levels. Yes, the first encounter of that mechanic being one that is easy to fuck up isn't great. All rise for the shining star of the stage. Our benevolent and bemuscled hero... The man with the golden biceps, Emperor Eddie. And Judge Rufus is here too. Okay, he's judging our performance. Attention, the gala auditions have commenced. His Majesty the Emperor will now receive the first performer. Miss Penny, take the stage. I'm gonna do yo-yo tricks for you with my new pet yo-yo. Look at my cool yo-yo tricks! Such good yo-yoing! Okay, the yo-yo did bite my hat slightly, but it's fine. The king very much liked the yo-yo. Splendid, remarkable show! But the yo-yo gets hungry and decides to eat all of the king's clothes. And now we are a fugitive. A crime has been committed. Criminal disrobing of the imperial personage. Criminal chaos in the editorium. It's all on record in the book of law, your multiple malevolent misdeeds. Young lady, you are a felon. And now we're on the run from the cops. That's the concept. We accidentally ate the king's clothes. We're gonna get locked up for 10,000 years. We can't let the penguin guards catch us. Go. Zoom, run away. A And now we're into actual levels. You hear the music start to kick in. Oh, I didn't show off. You can also do spin attacks with the yo-yo. Just charming. Isn't it charming? A little ice lolly. These are little sort of hidden nuts and bolts around the level. They unlock secret stuff later. Sometimes in levels you'll find people who have little quests for you, such as, oh, where are my 5 missing bolts? I need them to finish this building work. Oh, that's okay. We'll just fucking find them around the building site. There's little purple cogs and things. God, this game's movement system is so satisfying. Okay, we've got 3. There's 4, and there's the 5th. Hog. And now these people will come celebrate us at the end of the level. We've unbrainwashed them about us being evil, and they'll come be nice to us at the end of the level when we do a little party. Do a trick. Now we have penguins. These penguins will try and grab onto us and get us arrested. We gotta fight them off as best we can. I'm just gonna sort of swirl them off. See, this wire works perfectly well. Yeah, I can definitely feel the Super Lucky's Tale-esque vibes to this. I mean, look, you say poor penguins. Those penguins are cops. They had it coming. If you're gonna be not only a cop, but a cop that serves a monarch, you get no sympathy from me. This guy doesn't want his sandwich stolen by a pigeon. Left it up here. Gonna get his sandwich, bring it back down to him. I'm gonna try and sprint past these penguins as best I can. Let's go. Away from the penguins. Get onto this little boost thing. Yeah, imagine if this had been a new Sonic game. Imagine if this had come out today as, like, a new 3D Sonic. People would have fucking loved it, right? This would have had people going, oh yeah, the best that Sonic has been in years. Look at this. It's a charming, original, Sonic-inspired 3D platformer. Hooray, we did the mowing for him. He's happy. Yeah, going downhill. Go, go, go. Zoom, zoom, zoom. Oh, yeah. This is my only problem with this game. Is Occasionally, if you're standing in the wrong place when you get on a wire, your body hits the ground, it assumes you don't want to be on the wire anymore, and you fall. And if you're aware of it, you can avoid it. And I've weirdly not experienced it happen outside of the first level. Well, that tutorial level and then this first proper level. Beyond this, it's not really a problem. It's just a weird oversight that's not ideal. Yeah, so sometimes I need to remember, just jump off and be clear of the ground before you grab the wire. Don't try and grab the wire while you're still standing. It's not great that you have to do that, but... Okay, and you get more points at the end of the level if you can land on the top of this big, sort of stage thing with the multiple tiers. And then we're gonna try and do some yo-yo tricks for the crowd. And I'm bad at these. Okay, that was okay. We're trying to do three tricks in rapid succession. Oh, wrong way. My brain really doesn't interpret the spirally arrow, rotate the analog stick direction very well. My brain never does a good job of seeing the spiral and knowing which way I'm supposed to rotate the thing. Right, it's so fluid. It's so good. Now, I'm gonna quit. I'm not that much further into the game. I'm on, like, world 1-4, maybe? So I'm gonna go hop over to my own save, just to leave a little mystery of the opening of the game. But I'm gonna go do just a random level a little ever so slightly further in. It's still in the first world. I'm not even far enough in to know if... I guess there are bosses. If there are, I haven't encountered one yet. Okay. I'm apparently about 7% of the way in. 1-4. Have I tried the demo for Pepper Drill? No, but I have it downloaded. We could still try it tonight. Tonight is trying stuff from the Direct and playing about with things that were like, and it's available today! Okay, so this is where I am up to. What do you need? You need flowers, but you need them quickly. Okay. I'll try and get these flowers for you quickly, sir. Oh, the last ones are there. Is it just 4? I think I got them all in time. Oh no, there's flowers there. Okay, I got all the flowers. Cool. There's penguins stuck to me. I need to fight the penguins. Cops are trying to get me. By the way, would these games have been out last week if Microsoft hadn't had to apologize? My understanding is yes. My understanding is several of these games. So here's my okay. Here's what I've heard, and I don't know how much stock to put into this, but what I've been told is the reason that we did have some announcements last week, including some games came to the eShop last week on the day that all of those Twitter, like, not quite Nintendo Direct announcements happened, is that developers were told, basically, we would really, really, really appreciate it if you waited until next week. But if not, we can edit you out of the Direct and you can release today. But the Direct is not happening till next week. And that was a situation where some devs... my understanding is publicly they can't talk about it, but some devs who had been excited to be part of a Nintendo Direct had to just release their game because that was they couldn't move things around, and others delayed their game a week to still have the spotlight of a Direct. Again, I don't know how much stock to put in that, but I've heard more than one person put that forward. So take that for what you will. Okay, let's redo this. Let's get the flowers. Ah, come on. Okay, can I get these before the timer runs out? There's the last one. Oh, I missed them. You know what, screw it. I'm restarting the level so that I can get those flowers for the guy. Microsoft is so weird. It just shows you that loads of money still can't buy creativity and talent. They're a big corporate company that is like, they're part of Microsoft, and Microsoft's main thing isn't entertainment media, and as such, there are a bunch of executives that have to convey things to even less interested in me in video games other executives, and that's a tricky situation to have to navigate, I would imagine. Okay, don't touch the big red thing, because then more penguins will get after us. Oh god, there's so many. Okay, we got to the checkpoint. Cool. Remember when Microsoft bought Skype and now no one uses it anymore? Yeah, they really screwed their moment for Skype to be like a globally important program. They did not capitalize on that well. Fell. That's on me. Okay, penguins, no thank you. I do not buy your help on this day. Okay, let's tilt platform. Isn't Teams based on Skype? It might be. It's tough to know at this point. Come on, just make that jump, Laura. You got this. Okay, Teams is Skype for business. Okay, yeah. I know they both use the same, essentially the same framework. Here we go. I was surprised to see Fantasy Life at the presentation. That was the only one that got a solid date toward the end of... Oh, I shouldn't be trying to read a chat message while mid-swing. And that was the only one that got a solid date toward the last part of the year. Yeah, the next few weeks are going to be very much selling you on, like, what the last year of the Switch looks like. Because, like, we're less than a week away from the Pokemon Presents. Then, supposedly, we've got, I think, an indie direct in March, a full main direct in April, and then in June, big E3. Like, we are really, like, here is final big year of this system. Take it all in. Let's pull out all the stops, because there's not going to be much other chance to... You know, this is this last big hurrah year, as it were. The Pokemon Presents can't be worse than the previous two, can it? Were the previous two bad? The previous two had, like, Legends Arceus and Scarlet and Violet. And for any problems they had, both of them were, like, escalating degrees of open-world Pokemon. I didn't think either of those ones was terrible. Unless I misplayed, like, have I erased a Pokemon Presents in my head that was bad that happened in between then and now? Pink Pokemon games are usually November, like the week or so before Thanksgiving. Yeah, there's a lot of rumblings about what we're getting this year in Pokemon. A lot of rumblings about Unova, a lot of rumblings about Johto. Definitely not Gen 10 or next gen. The previous two were mainly about Scarlet and Violet DLC and lots of mobile and merch stuff. Oh, you're right. Yeah, I'm thinking 2020 and 2021. Those were good years. When they told us to come back next week, and it was Pokemon Unite. Oh, that one. Yeah. Look, it's Pokemon. Even at its worst, I'll have seen Pokemon. I won't have had a bad time. It's very hard for a Pokemon Presents to be a bad time for me because I got to see a Pokemon or two. I'm very easy to please in the Pokemon regards. show me a Pikachu, and I'll go, oh, fuck yeah, that was a Pikachu, wasn't it? Love them. Love that little mouse. Oh. Yeah, that's not... This is not where I was meant to be going to, was it? There's... Yeah, no. Oopsie. Yeah, I aimed for entirely the wrong spot there. Let's try that again. Old gens on NSO, new TCG RPG are interesting. New Switch spin-off, I'll be happy enough. I suspect if I was going to put like some categories, I think there is plenty of hints to suggest either Unova or Johto getting something. That something is probably going to be either a Legends game or a Let's Go. I think that NSO releases of the old gen of some of the old gen Pokemon games, I think, is like a slam dunk. I think a lot of time will be spent on Pokemon Unite, of course, because that's their big money thing they want to squeeze. I would love to see like a proper Pokemon TCG RPG again. Oh god, give me it, please. God, this game is beautiful. I still really like Let's Go Pikachu and Eevee, and I am in the small camp of people who really wanted to see an additional, like, a new one of those. Like, I would have happily taken a Let's Go Johto, and I still would. I think Let's Go is charming. Okay, how do we get these giant screws loose? Okay, I see. Oh. I need to not hit and mash the dash button. That's me on the dash button. Okay, I need to remember where to find that little bonus stage, though. Yeah, like, I'm not good at this game, but I enjoy it a lot. And it's one of those, like, I can see how people more talented than me are going to make this game look beautiful in gameplay. For me, it's like, yeah, I'll functionally get through the gameplay. I'm having a lot of fun sucking at this game. Feels very satisfying to move around even when I am dying in the process. Like, that swing mechanic is so good. Okay, Okay. Cool, I think I did it. I think I did the level. Cool. It throws me out here. Lovely, that is actually really convenient. And there's a checkpoint. Right, what do you want quest-wise? Somebody lost this letter, can you take it back to them? Sure. Who needs the letter? I don't know, but we'll work it out. Oh, penguins. Penguins gonna hassle me. No. I've got a letter to deliver. Don't hassle me, penguins. I'm doing important work. I'm delivering a letter to a mystery person I don't know. There you go. There's your letter. Your juicy secrets are safe. I mean, mean, look, we're still in the first world. I'm sure there will be different visual aesthetics per world. I would imagine. And, like, for a team's first ever, like, 3D platformer, I think it is a very promising start. Like, I hope they are given permission to continue expanding on this idea. Oh no! Ah, so many penguins! Penguins, penguins everywhere! Penguins, penguins everywhere! Penguins, penguins everywhere! Oh, freedom! Ooh, there is a burger which will allow me to smash big things. It's my big power mode power-up. I'm briefly very powerful. Nothing stands in my way. I'm fueled by meat and bread. Oh, that's what I'm trying to do. I'm trying to locate and step on these switches. Oh no, penguins, get away. I need more burger. Okay, second tier, that's fine. We made it to the second floor. Okay. Take my time. Hooray, I did the directions right this time. I did my little yo-yo performance for everyone. I didn't find any of the little hexagonal things hidden in this level, but it'll do. Yet another game with anti-penguin propaganda, shaking my head, 0 out of 10. I'm sorry that everything's... Look, if these penguins weren't cops, I wouldn't have to beat them up, but they keep trying to take me to the king, and, like, don't fucking abandon me to a monarch. Oh god, so many penguins. Okay. Oh, this is gorgeous. I love this game's animations. Like, there's such good use of 3D in this. Ah, it's still chasing me. Avoid the net. Get over here. Bounce. Up we go. Hit this. Speed off. Oh, this is a really neat... I like this level design a lot. Oh, okay, didn't get the hammer in time. I need to... Okay. Okay, let's re-go. Go, go, go. At least it's reasonably lenient with checkpointing, I find. Oh no, gotten by the cop ball. Right? Damn cops. Ah. Yeah, don't even try. I keep trying to get on the yo-yo for speed at that point, and I'm like, no, because then I have to jump off the yo-yo, and there's, like, too long of an animation there. Just run on foot, trust that you've got enough time. Don't overthink it. It's... Ah. Oh no, they got me in the net. Come on. Ah, god, goddamn.
Okay, okay, there we go. We speed around that corner to make up for it. Okay, hammer through the walls. Oh, I could have hammered that wall. Oh, there was a very hammerable wall there I missed. I can see where there's a secret I could have had. Jump off the edge before you. Oh, okay. I'm gonna watch out for it. Yes. Jump off the edge before you try and get on the wire, because this game, that's the one thing that isn't great about this game that I'm otherwise very much enjoying. It's a minor enough thing, I'm really hoping they can just patch that. Oh, no, okay. Couldn't smash it. That's fine. Now, jump off the edge and then grab it. There we go. The yo-yo driving feels really good in these kind of moments. Got me. We got this. Complete World 1. Okay. Just fucking run on foot. Run. Get the burger. Yes. The movement mechanics are great. I'm not great at them, but they are great. If that distinction makes sense. Okay, go. Oh, that NPC is such a problem. Okay, now I can hop onto the thing and smash through all of these. The burger. Oh, I lost burger momentum. Ah. Ah, why did I not go through? I should have gone through the floor there. I need to work out what I did wrong there, because I should, as the burger, have gone through the floor. Ah, no, completely failed the
The yo-yo swing jump, that's again, that's on me. I know exactly what I did wrong. Conservation of momentum is really nice in this. Ah. Until you hit that fucking NPC and lose all that momentum again. Okay, there we go, there we go. Ugh. There we go, I needed to jump while on the burger to slam down. Ooh. Oh. Oh no, incompetent hero, I'm really sorry. I hope I didn't drain too much of your mobile data. And I know how unfortunate that can be. Ooh, new aesthetic area. Cool. Person who wanted to see some visual variety, hopefully you'll see it here. Okay, you're always set to 360p when out. Okay, that's not the worst thing in the world then. Ooh, what is this reminding me of? Aesthetically. Cosmonius High? Is that what I'm thinking of? This color palette is bringing something to my mind. These bozo bought the blueprints. I'm gonna knock down a wall. Oh, that wall over there, I see. Okay, I needed to get the hammer before the thing closed, I see. Tynanworth, thank you very much for the 34 months of sub. I'm supposed to be writing, but stream has lights and colours. Do you think my editor will accept that as an excuse if I miss my deadline? If I were your editor, I would accept it, because I'd go, you know what, sometimes it be like that. Depends on the editor. Ooh, sorry, I've just realised I have a work message that might be important. I'm not sure. I need a second. Okay, that'll do. I'll get back to it later. I've not seen the show Gangs of London based on the PSP game, no. Ooh, oh, ah, damn. Oh, I see. I think what we might do is finish this level and then try the demo for, what's it called? Pepper Grinder? Which looks really cool. We might give the demo for that a look. Oh. Ah, I see. Oh, okay, don't get pushed down into the murky water, I see. A high-ranking member of the Yakuza has been arrested trying to traffic nuclear stuff into another country. Interesting. I haven't tried out the Tomb Raider remasters. I have a bunch of other stuff on my plate. I don't really have the time at the second to check out remasters, because my brain's like... I was never the biggest person for the original games anyway, and I'm like... I think my time's better served trying new stuff at the second, with the time that I have. It's one of those, if I'm not desperate to play it, it's kind of having to go on the back burner at the second. Ah, come on. There we go. I have seen the Borderlands film trailer. I'm glad to see a video game adaptation film where three of the four main characters are women and two of them are older women. Or at least the ones that are humans and not Jack Black voicing a robot. You get my point. Of the four main humans visible on screen, three of them are women and two of them are older women, and that's nice to see in a thing like this. I see. Okay. And it's nice seeing, what's her name? I keep forgetting. Not the one playing Lilith. I'm blanking on the woman's name. I'm gonna kick myself as soon as... Jamie Lee Curtis, that's it. It's nice seeing Jamie Lee Curtis get to have some fun video game roles, because she has said for years she wants to do video game stuff, she wants to do anime stuff. She has like a list of characters that she's like, this character in this piece of nerd media, I want to be them. And it's nice seeing that sort of pan out and get to play that set of characters she's been sort of looking forward to. Okay, come on. Oh. How did I fuck that up? Yeah, that's the thing. I've not heard, like, stellar things about those Tomb Raider remasters, and as such, they're just not high on my to-do list. I'm really bad at dodging this water spout. Come on. We got this. Just have to do the palm tree thing and do it correctly. There we go. We're getting better at that. Do I wait for it to be all the way down, or do I leave it while it's up and swing under it? That's the thing I'm trying to work out that I'm currently stumbling on. $4.50 for a Canadian for a large fries. God damn. That's a bit fucking ridiculous, honestly. Racetrack, zoom! Been a busy start of the year for stuff that I am personally invested in, plus things that I have work obligations with. That combination has been surprisingly busy for the start of the year. Okay, I see. There's a water thing here, so if I can get into that, it's probably going to shoot me up into the air. And give me a chance to... Okay, at least get onto the second tier. Okay, let's go. I forget, what were your thoughts on the Dead Space remake? I'm playing it now and loving it so far. I think it's an improvement of the original game. I generally think it's a smart modernization. I think it's one of the better attempts of modernizing a thing like that that it has been recently. I feel like it justifies its existence pretty well. I think it's pretty decent. Right, we're gonna leave this one for here, for now. But let's jump into a little bit of something else that dropped during the Direct today. Let's pop into Pepper Grinder, the demo, which looks gorgeous from what I've seen. I'm very curious about it. I don't know if we have a release date for this one yet. What did you think of Hi-Fi Rush and Sea of Thieves coming to PS5 but not Switch? Has Sea of Thieves been announced for PS5 yet? Because last I saw, here was the situation. A trailer for Hi-Fi Rush was released on, I think it was the South American Bethesda YouTube channel, and then taken down. And it wasn't meant to have been announced. Okay, it has been announced now. Cool. Give me a second to read the thing, because I'm not up to speed on this. Pentiment, coming to PS4, PS5, Sea of Thieves, coming to PlayStation. So, here is my, like... Okay, here is my suspicion right now on where the thing is. Hi-Fi Rush was definitely planned for Switch. There is currently, in the code for Hi-Fi Rush on PC, a Switch-themed t-shirt. Now, it's entirely possible that it just wasn't running the way they wanted it to, and they cancelled those plans at some point. I suspect, if that is the case, which is probably likely, they're planning it for Switch 2. They're just going to hold it till Switch 2, release it then. That being said... I reckon it's still coming. I think, like, the fact that Nintendo Switch themed shirt is in the files says they put work into trying to make a Switch port happen. They want it on Nintendo. I see no reason why they wouldn't bring it to Nintendo. I generally think I feel very similarly about Sea of Thieves. I think Sea of Thieves have done tweets, like, implying it's coming to Switch. They have done tweets being like, this platform's red and this platform's blue. They've been hinting at it. Again, my suspicion is either it's going to get announced at a later point because they're still unsure. Like, it'll come after PlayStation. They're just not sure if they can get the performance where they want it to be. Or they've gone, Switch 2 is around the corner. We're playing nice with Nintendo now. We can ask them to give us dev kits and we can... Like, Sea of Thieves and Hi-Fi Rush portably as, like, launch window titles for Switch successor a year from now, I think is probably a better proposition for Microsoft than try and force them onto the current Switch only to a year from now be releasing, you know, in enhanced ports or, like, upgrade paths. Limited Run is doing a physical version of Hi-Fi Rush. Ooh. Just for PlayStation or for Xbox as well? Because a Nintendo platform physical version of Hi-Fi Rush, I would fucking love. I want a physical version of Hi-Fi Rush regardless, so whatever platforms it's on, I'll grab one of them, probably. Also, Hi-Fi Rush got rated for Switch as a platform in the... I think it was Australia. So, like, clearly, the intention to bring it to Nintendo is or was there. Why do you need a separate account for both New Zealand and Australia? Well, here's the thing. New Zealand is, in theory, the fastest place to access games on the eShop from. But sometimes you go to definitely real New Zealand and not a website where someone will sell you New Zealand eShop cards. And they're completely sold out of New Zealand eShop cards because a highly anticipated game is about to come out and you can play it 12 hours early and therefore all their eShop cards have sold out. And so the next best thing is to hop on a flight to Australia, where you're not going to get to play it 12 hours early, but maybe like 11 or 10 hours early, like a couple of hours later you'll still have access. So in that, like, not ideal scenario, you take a couple of hours flight to Australia and buy some of their eShop cards because New Zealand sold out of theirs. Hopefully that makes sense. Hi-Fi Rush Twitter. We've heard the crowd. We're collaborating with Limited Run Games on physical editions, PlayStation and Xbox. Stay tuned. Cool. Anyway, let's try this demo. What are the options looking like? Anything? Ooh, game speed. Game speed is nice to have. Also, Bluehead protagonist game. You see why I had to check this out tonight. Eat me! Oh no! They stole the treasure! I gotta go get him! Oh no. Oh, redhead enemy lady. Goddamn. I gotta beat you up and or kiss you. Now I have a drill. Incompetent Hero, when are you going to find an extra 100 plus hours in my schedule? Because that's when I'll stream Persona 3. There you go. Okay, Hooray, you can sort of drill through the sand and you hop up in the air and do cool maneuvers. Doesn't this seem cool? Look at this. Okay, can I pierce you? I can pierce you from underneath, aha. Okay, let's go. It's such a neat concept, this. Haha, got myself a coin. Causes the drill that will pierce the heavens. Yep. Believe in the me that believes in you and your ability to complete the level, or such. God, it's been a while since I've watched Gurren Lagann. Believe in the me that believes in you. Okay, what's, oh! B, okay, so we're... Oh, okay, there's a time delay on me able to use that boost. Aha. Art style of a DS game in the best possible way is a really good way to describe this. Aha, I used the drill to operate the tool, haha. I like that there's the blue there to sort of signify this is one you got a boost on, even if I'm not doing it well. Aha! Oh, there was a coin down there. I saw the coin. I saw you, coin. How long would it take Steph and Conrad to suss out a fake AI Laura on Pokeposition? Depends how quickly Laura, the fake AI Laura tried to move them on to actually talking about video games or not. Okay. Come on. This feels like it's gonna be one of those games I will love watching people play. I'm gonna kind of suck at playing myself. Do the drill. Oh, I gotta press that while I'm still in the ground. Okay. It's not on a timer. It's, am I still in the ground? Then it works. Oh, I am understanding these mechanics more now that I am having to actually use them. Aha! Oh, you can just chain those. Okay. Hello, mole. Oh, big friend. Okay. How generous is this checkpointing? Oh, very generous. Ah. Yes, generous checkpointing, difficult platforming challenge. Short little bursts. I see the Celeste of it. Okay. Okay, come on. Ah, come on. I want that gold coin, and I'm gonna work out how to get it. Oh. Ah. That's how you do it. Incompetent Hero says you need affiliate links or something. You sold me on two games today. I'm glad that I've sold you on two games today. I'm not a big fan of doing affiliate links, and I don't like... the idea, like, I don't like the thought to be in people's head of maybe Laura's only saying this game is good so that I'll buy it and she'll make money off affiliate links. It just feels gross to me, but I'm glad that I've helped you find things that you're like, oh, I want to play that. That is all I want to achieve with checking out cool games, is hopefully, you know, either a thing that you're not going to play, you get to see regardless, or I've seen the next thing I'm going to get into. That's my aim. Like, I get it's entirely possible to do affiliate links without, you know, there are people who pull it off, but I feel skeezy if affiliate links are a thought in my, like, if that thought crosses my mind while I am telling you how much I am or am not enjoying a game, that's gonna encourage me towards the it's good, buy it through my link end of things. You know, no matter how much I try and temper that, I would imagine. I always want to be like, there is zero financial incentive for me to tell you a game is good if it's not. I'm telling you games, I think a game is good because I'm having fun with it. Oof. Ooh, I like this quite drastic change in scene and setting so fast. How different it's making it feel, even though it's theoretically unchanged gameplay. This feels very good. I'm getting to grips with it. Oh, such generous checkpointing. I am so appreciative of this. Again, this is like Celeste. I don't mind a game being hard as balls if it's gonna offer me plenty of checkpoints. Is there something here? Am I seeing something? Aha! Aha! I've sussed out your secrets, game. I understand what your visual language is telling me. Oh, such generous checkpoints! Haha! Oh, this is something kind of special. I hope there's a decent narrative here. I suspect not, but I like, that's the one thing I'm like, ooh, if you threw in a good narrative here, I'd be real fucking sold. Okay, I need to get up into here and then across. Okay. Aha. There we go. Up and into there and through. And up and through. Haha. I love the little animation of the key rotating on the end of your drill as you take it toward the lock. There's a decent length to this. I hate the feeling of getting into the swing of things only to have it stop right then. I have no idea what the length is like on this. I don't know if they've said anywhere. That is obviously a factor to keep in mind, but I mean, initial impressions, like, it's worth playing this demo, I think, because it takes a second to get your head around the drill mechanic, but once you've got it going, it feels really good. I don't know how well the feel of it conveys over video, because it feels good. Does the HD rumble feel good on this? It seems like an opportunity to take advantage. It's very good tactile feedback in terms of, like, giving you useful information. I can feel the kind of contact I am making and how fast I'm moving through the surface via the way it's vibrating, and that is appreciated. I'm curious how much there is in this demo. Anything else I wanted to check out tonight? Geometry Survivor is the other thing I kind of want to give a look before we finish tonight. I'm curious. It's a new Survivor's game that's like £3 on Switch, and I'm very curious what its deal is. Oh, mines. Okay, I'm enjoying the... Oh, I am enjoying the gameplay variety already on show here. This is nice. Okay, so I can jump onto here. Oh, this is an interesting puzzle of a stage. I don't think Geometry Survivor is made by the Geometry Wars people, but it's definitely trying to invoke the aesthetic of Geometry Wars. And that is enough that I'm like, okay, you've pulled from an inspiration I like. Let's see whether you live up to it. Oh. Okay, so that's open. And now I come around here and pop this and aha! Oh, I see. So we've got a... Oh, it's setting that off. Aha! Wrong button. Here we go. To angle up. There we go. Oh god, this game feels satisfying. I need to tell Conrad about this. Conrad would really enjoy this game. Have you tried Spirit Hunter's Infinite Horde yet? I have it on PS5. I'm loving having permanent progression be via Massive Path of Exile style skill tree. I've tried it. I can't quantify it. It just didn't grab me the way that I need a Survivor's game to. I'm not saying it's bad by any means. It just isn't the one that stuck. It's a very crowded field, and it's one of those where it's like, if you're not one of the two or three survivors I have room for in my life. You know, I try a lot of them, and I try and give them each a good amount of time. I don't want to rush them. And I love experimenting with what's there in the space. It's just occasionally some of them I'm like, you are not the chosen one. You are not Neo. You are not here to liberate us from the Matrix. The Renfield one is surprisingly interesting. For a movie tie-in, it had a good number of its own original ideas. I didn't stick with it long-term, but I got a good amount of play out of it, and I was surprised that it was as good as it was. Like, right now, the one I have time for in my life right now is Deep Rock Galactic Survivors, which I might do a stream of at some point in the future once we've gotten through Dondoko Island in a bit more, like a dragon. But, oh, that's a good one. Okay, come on. I need to get good. Come on, Laura, get good. What am I missing here? Oh, knock that up. How do I safely set these off? Not like that. That's not the safe way to do it. Oh, I see what I have to do. Aha! Hit the little bug up at it. Oh, not that. Okay. What I need to do is I need to set off this one here. Aha! Can't figure out the blue thing to get speed? Literally, while you're still in the dirt, you press B, and it dashes you out of the dirt. But it sort of dashes you in a straight line, so you have to be committed to your direction. You get less maneuverability to get out. So, you gotta press it just the jump button just before you exit, and then you can, haha, like that! Oh... Oof. That was rough, but we'll survive. Yeah, speedruns of this game are going to be ridiculous. People with more talent than me will do wonderful things with this. I'm going to assume this is the last level of the demo. I feel like this makes sense to be a last bit of... Yeah. That's really neat. That feels really promising. I don't know if we have a date for this, but that demo feels really good. Okay, let's give Geometry Survivor a look. That's going to be the last thing we check out today. Why are so many games using me as a main character? Because I am the main character of life. No, that's me being facetious. I don't know if this is going to be any good, and it wasn't technically a Nintendo Direct thing, but let me give it a look. Geometry Survivor. And I find this on Twitch to category. It is on Twitch. There are two people viewing it on Twitch. We are now the biggest Geometry Survived stream on Twitch right now. Okay, so it's sort of an Asteroids-esque auto-shooter. The lighting effects are nice. Okay, we're just shooting at nearest enemy, no matter what direction they are, I think. Okay, there are outer walls that I have to be aware of. I'm trapped within a box, so I gotta keep that in mind. Okay. Launches a boomerang at the nearest target, then returns the ship, an autonomous projectile that flies around and wreaks havoc on enemies. Detects nearby enemies and fires a burst of bullets in their direction. Let's try proximity blaster. Oh, it needs enemies to get, like, real close before it will activate that one. Okay, I see. The blue and yellow things, I think, are experience. Simple aesthetic, but it's looking nice. Fires bullets at the nearest target. That's auto-aim. Black hole creates a field that pulls all enemy ships inward and destroys them. Pulls all loot towards your ship. Okay, let's pull loot towards us more. Phasing. Become temporarily invulnerable to increase movement speed. Spawns an allied ship that follows you around and shoots enemies with explosive missiles. Sounds nice. Fires projectiles clockwise around the ship. Let's have the allied ship. Oh, that little pink one is my friend. Oh, I stopped to look at chat and I very quickly died. Right. Permanent upgrade shop. Extra health, invulnerability, reroll loot magnet. Movement speed increase. Let's sort loot magnet first, if I can afford it. Oh, that's like 100. Can I afford anything? No, that run got me like nothing. Okay, let's pay attention this time. Oh, my health is literally just, it's three hits and you're dead. For some reason, I was looking at the experience meter in the top left thinking that was my health, but no, I have three hearts in the top right. Rotating laser around the player. Sure, let's try quad laser. Ooh. Well, that's fun. It's very shortly lived, but I would like to power that up and make that good. Make a little slowdown force field would be nice. I don't know how long it lasts for. Does it just stay here permanently? Oh, okay. Or will a new one get made at some point? Okay, every so often a slowdown force field happens. I see. I don't know what that yellow thing I see there is. Spawns a projectile and releases it after a short delay. Let's become temporarily invulnerable. What's this? I don't know if that yellow thing was good or bad. I think it was bad. I could do with like a little more explanation of what things are. Like a tiny bit of tutorial wouldn't hurt. Yeah, go autonomous projectile. Go fly around and destroy stuff. Yeah, only three health and seemingly no way to recover health is, that's fairly unforgiving. Okay, yeah. Interesting game, not one that I think I'm going to do a lot of playing on stream. I will stick with it a little bit. It doesn't feel bad by any means, but I feel like I need to... I need to get my claws into it a bit more. Let's give it one more run. Let's give it one more go. I think the thing is, it's got the mechanics down, but it hasn't got the personality. A lot of my favorite games in this genre, I feel like I'm playing as a weird little character. And there's something a little impersonal about this design, and I'm struggling to put a word to it. You want to see me play as a Beardy Miner? I mean, if I had a controller I could sync up to the Steam Deck right now, we could do a little bit of Deep Rock Galactic Survivor. Let's see. I'll do this run, and I will see if I can conveniently get the Steam Deck up and running on stream to run Deep Rock Survivor off of. We can maybe do a run of that, and then that'll be end of stream. Oh, another stream. I will do it at some point. I might try and do one run of it tonight if people are into it. It's just on PC for now, yeah. It's in early access, but it's very well optimized. It runs, like, super well on the Steam Deck. I wouldn't be surprised if it got ports. It's in early access right now. That's upgrade number two, the quad laser. Yeah, Void Scrappers is good. Void Scrappers is a good game. I aesthetically, I like the art design of what this has got going on. Mechanically, there's no way I would pick this over Void Scrappers. Void Scrappers is an infinitely more mechanically satisfying game than this. Look, if you're someone like me that is interested in the Vampire Derivers space, the Survivor likes, I'm glad I picked this up. It's interesting. It's not one I'm going to be rushing to tell, you know, Stefan Comrade to check out. Try the... Ooh, Black Hole. Black Hole's fun. Okay, it's got a few of its own, like, unique feeling weapons. I appreciate that. If nothing else, some of these weapons do feel distinct from other stuff. Even if just in execution, if not, Ooh, garlic equivalent. Ooh, give me the garlic equivalent. I say I'm excited about weapons that don't feel like Vampire Survivors, but you offer me a garlic and I'm like, just give me the garlic. Every Vampire Survivors game needs a garlic, please. Okay. Yeah, we're gonna leave this one here. I'm gonna see if I can quickly set up the Steam Deck, if we can do a quick little Vampire Survivors. Let's see how doable this is going to be, because I don't have a controller that is charged and synced to the Steam Deck on hand, but I can't imagine it would be too hard to get this set up. Let's get this into the Steam Deck dock. Is it hard to set up the Steam Deck for streaming? It should pop up now. This bit's not hard. Oh, this is me checking out Cookie Cutter. The main thing is, do I have a controller synced up to it? And the answer at this second is no. Oh, I jostled it slightly. How dare I jostle? Okay, so what I need to do is... I'm using the Steam Deck's own controls for the second to... quit out. Let's try and sync a controller. This Xbox controller I can probably sync. Oh yeah, that'll do. That. LSC Pro Controller, yeah, Lick Pro Controller. Oh, it's trying to connect to the Xbox now. Come on, don't connect to the Xbox. Xbox, I don't need you to turn on right now. Okay, Steam Deck, come on, let's back out of Bluetooth and back in. Come on, find me a Bluetooth controller. Oh, I saw you, Xbox. Do I have to keep the button held down for me to see you? Xbox. Oh no, I'm aware there's a pair button. I'm trying to use the pair button to get it to show up as a Bluetooth device on my thing. I am aware there is a pair button. The pair button is what I am trying to use, and I'm not sure why it's not working. Trust me. First point of bearing a controller, it would be pair the controller. Okay, you know what? Disconnect. Yeah, in a world, there's not... I appreciate your trying to tech support. Trust me, I'm doing the basic troubleshooting. Now you're trying to turn the Xbox on again. Why are you trying to turn the Xbox on again? Okay, one more try at this. Show all devices. Okay. This, I think I know how to do. Let's just get my DualSense to... What is it? It's that button and this button together. Get into pairing mode. Okay, I think my DualShock trying to... Bluetooth pair. DualSense wireless controller. There we go. This'll do. Cool. Oh, I need to check out Ultros still. Let's do one run of Deep Rock Galactic Survivors while we're here. yeah, you can pair a DualSense 5 with other things, yeah. I'm gonna have to remember to repair it to the PlayStation before we do the next stream, but that's fine, I can get that to go. Steam is pretty good at pairing stuff. You'd think that, but that Xbox controller just does not want to unpair from the Xbox. The Xbox has turned itself on again. Off you go, Xbox. One sec. I need to tell my bloody Xbox to turn off. Okay, let's do a basic run on the basic level. Let's be the engineer. The engineer is fun. Start with some turrets. So, this is Deep Rock Galactic Survivors. It is a 3D character model, Vampire Survivors-like. You are playing as a dwarf, and as such, you are responsible for mining resources. My starting weapon is turrets. I have to stand still for a second for them to spawn in, and they shoot at the nearest target. We're picking upgrades for just one weapon. It's specific levels, you get to pick additional weapons. Level 5 is the first time we'll get another weapon. For some reason, my Steam Deck has just disconnected from the screen. There it is. Cool. Let's get a increased reload speed. That is always good. Up in the top right, I have an objective for this level where I'll get bonuses if I do it, which is mine Morkite, this material here. The turrets are really good for mining quests because I can be mining while the guns are handling shooting for me. This upgrade doesn't actually give me any bonuses, but it increases my weapon level by 2, whereas this one would give me 10% damage but only increase it by 1. I'll show you in a second why leveling up your weapon faster can sometimes be a worthwhile trade-off. Because when you reach increments of 6 on your level ups, you get significantly better rewards. So this is level 5. One sec. We're going to... What weapon do we want? Grenade shooter, defensive drones. Let's get electrical turrets. This is another we stand still and something deploys, but this one arcs electricity. But yes, when we get to level 5 with the turrets in a second, you'll see why I sort of skipped a level to get to level 6 quicker. So we'll take a... Here we go. You start getting overclocks, and overclocks are very powerful upgrades. We're going to take the tank tracks. The turrets that spawn now won't be stuck in place. They can follow me around. Only the shooty turrets, not the Tesla coil ones. But this gives me a little bit of ability to run away from a swarm and have my turrets kind of come with me and not just abandon me where I am. So I'm going to sort of back away and let my Tesla coils do damage over time. Try and get them to explode these little explodey enemies at the back. To let me pick up a lot of experience. So I'm trying to get each of my weapons to at least level 6 as quickly as I can so that I can get at least one good overclock on each. Level 18, a weapon gets a unbalanced overclock, which is like a ridiculously powerful upgrade. They are very worth getting if you can. At the very least, let's get at least a level 6 on each weapon. This red crystal is health, so I'm going to grab some of that. Ooh, oh, there's a supply drop. I need to go find the supply drop. Incompetent Hero says, boy, this being a follow-up to Geometry Survivors really highlights the need for a sense of identity. This is so much more engaging. Right? This is what I meant. Geometry Survivors wasn't mechanically bad, but it lacked personality. This is what I meant. Okay. So there is a supply drop with some good, health-based level up here. But there's a bunch of rock in the way, so I need to clear this circle, the landing area, or I can't get this upgrade that is going to be a very good, valuable upgrade for me. So I'm going to do my best to clear this area out. And in doing so, this little meter will load up and I should get a really nice bonus. 70 extra health and 2 life regen. That sounds good. Now the boss for this level has spawned. Which is this sort of big fucker here. When we kill them, this floor of the run will end, and we will have a limited time to go get in the dropship to go down to the next floor. I'm gonna take a second to try and mine some gold, because gold will be helpful for getting upgrades between floors. Turrets explode when they move, or turrets pick up experience and nearby materials. Let's get some freebies. Okay, I've got 30 seconds to follow this green line. Grab a little bit of nitro. I think I've got enough time to grab a little bit of nitro on the way through. Okay, I have 15 seconds to get to the drop pod. And in we go, and we go down a floor. And there are five floors before one final boss on the fifth and final floor. And that is a run. This is on the easiest difficulty for now in the starting area. We got some nitro and some gold, so we can buy some between level upgrades, which is good. Increased damage, lifetime. Yeah, that'll do. Do you just lose it if you don't make it back? If you don't make it back, the run ends there. You still get experience and some money and any of the materials you mined for between level upgrades, but the run ends if you don't make it there in 30 seconds. So getting on the thing is important. Okay. That big supply drop that we sort of mined out earlier, that is the second thing on the bar at the top. It'll drop in at a certain point. You can see when in the level it's going to spawn in. We are at level 12. At level 15, we'll get a third weapon, which is nice. Prepare to fight for your life. The big swarm is okay, approaching. Big swarm coming. I'm going to back myself into a corner and then dig through the wall as stuff approaches, and then I can have it all sort of follow me through the Tesla coils. It does have a little bit of a StarCraft to it. I hadn't really considered that, but I get it. Increase my weapon level by 3. Yes, please. That gets me closer to my next overclock. Yeah, I want the drop pod to drop here, but there's dangerous enemies around and I can't finish drilling it out right now. Let's get... I'm going to go, like, a very deploying turrets heavy build. Let's deploy flamethrower turrets. Experience anytime I mine rock. That would be good. Now, every now and then, I stand still and a bunch of stuff deploys and I do big damage where I'm stood. Yeah, this just went into early access. I think it's like £8. Definitely feels worthwhile. It is fascinating. Okay, let's try and get... Do you need to press buttons for this one? All I'm doing is analog stick and occasionally pressing the X button or the A button to confirm menu selections. Otherwise, it's just analog stick. I'm automatically mining the rock. I can shoot while I'm mining. Everything just automatically happens by context of being stood near things. Like, you could very much do a one-handed setup of this using just a joystick and occasionally a button. Let's re-roll. Level 12, I get another overclock. Let's change the turrets so they shoot plasma bullets. Okay, and the boss for this floor has appeared. Hopefully at some point it'll support touchscreen so I don't need a controller like Vampire Survivors. Yeah, I don't know if it... I haven't tested. I don't believe it currently does, but What might be worth trying is seeing if you can sync a Joy-Con to it on PC. If you can Bluetooth a Joy-Con to PC, you could probably one-handed single Joy-Con play it if that works as a setup. Let's try and get an unbalanced overclock on something. Let's try and get one of the overpowered powers. I think this might be one that if you could Bluetooth a Joy-Con, you could probably make it a one button, one stick, one hand deal. Well done. Right. Up the damage there. Get the experience boost. Pick up radius. We're already on floor 3. And in the top right, you can see a bunch of sort of ongoing quests that are me trying to unlock stuff. So, like, level up this character to a certain level, level a certain weapon up to a certain level, collect X amount of this resource with this character. I can't use Joy-Cons, but I do have an adapted Xbox controller I can use when my hands are up to analog sticks. Yep, that's fair. I was like, it might not help, but I thought it was worth suggesting. But yes. The devs for this have been really, really responsive. It might be worth just going, hey, your game looks really cool. Is there any chance you would consider adding touchscreen support? They've been very good at taking on feedback. Okay, they're coming in close. I gotta back out. I gotta get out of here.
Can't drop supplies for you yet. Prep the landing zone for impact.
This one makes me want to be a better port.
Okay. Let's at least try and get this to level 6 so we can get the flamethrower's first upgrade. Achoo! Get all this experience I left behind up here earlier. Fourth weapon. Ooh, the breach cutter's really fun. This shoots at the biggest group of enemies it can find. Like two little balls and does like a line of plasma between them, hitting anything it bounces across, which is really fun. Okay, let's hit level 6 on this. Add more beams, sure. More flamethrower beams. Right, the targeting by where is the biggest, like, the largest number of enemies to target at once is a really cool targeting option. It's the one that, when I was telling Steph about it on Podquisition today, they were like, ooh, haven't seen a survivor's target via that metric. And I'm like, that's cool, right? NXP when you take damage, sure. Reroll. I wanna upgrade my turret thing. Come on, let me get those last like 3 levels in my turret so I can get a big overclock. Two more levels, and then I can make my little purple shooty turrets go ridiculous. One more. Oh, I was supposed to be collecting these flowers on this level. I completely forgot about my side objective. Okay. One more level up. Oh, drop pod is here. Gotta run. Come on, give me that level up on the way out. There's experience there. Let me take it. You don't want to give me that last level in turret. You don't want me to have the cool overpowered turret, do you, game?
Stage 3 done and dusted, miner. We'll have a good meal ready for you when you return.
I can't afford any of the between level upgrades. We're on the fourth floor. Next floor will be the final one.
Let's get out of here.
Yes, a character in a survivor's game where you have to stand still to deploy their things, and a lot of their things get stuck in place, so you kind of have to stick near where you dropped your weapon, is a fun, it's a fun gimmick. It's got a good feel to it. One where you've got to kind of hunker down in place more than run away is a nice change of pace. You've got to be a little bit of a tank.
Swarm detected. Get ready. They'll be with you shortly.
Come on, level up. Come on. Oh, I need to go find some gold so that I can reroll. I want that overclock. Oh, here we go. Overclock. Add 3 extra turrets or 150% fire rate for minus 15% accuracy. Let's go for 3 extra turrets. We can have so many more turrets now. So I've gone from having 2 or 3 turrets to having like 5 or 6 now. Because I went all the way up to level 18 on a single weapon. And that's your sort of incentive to like focus in on one weapon, is when you hit that level 18, you get the big upgrades.
Prepare to fight for your life. The big swarm is approaching.
Okay, big swarm is coming. Do my best to get some gold if I can. Before I gotta run. Okay, my health isn't great, but it'll do. How high can I push the level of one weapon? Do I get anything beyond 18? So much experience up there, though. I want that experience. It's not safe. Run. Okay, up the damage on all my plasma weapons. That'll get my many, many turrets more powerful. Jump that 3 levels up. Oh, my flamethrower turrets slow down. Oh no, my Tesla coils slow down nearby enemies now. Power that up. But yes, This is easily my favorite Vampire Survivors type game in a long time. It's right up there with like Vampire Survivors, Bone Razor Minions. It's in that contention. I think I prefer this to Bone Razor Minions. It's right up there, despite having only just come into early access. It's neat. Right, let's power that up. There's the boss of the level has shown up. That's good. Okay, time to flee.
It will leave without you.
Ooh. Oh, these exploding guys being near the exit is rough. There we go, there we go. Final stage, and then it's going to be bedtime for me. I hope people have enjoyed this scattershot stream. I think Ben Razor Minions is very good. I prefer this. Okay, let's get some health, get some nitro, let's get some resources. So this final floor, there are a bunch of eggs and then one very big egg. You defeat the small eggs, you unleash the thing in the big egg. You survive it, you win. So we've broken the first egg open. Gonna do our best to kill the thing inside. Ooh. That Tesla coil upgrade that slows down enemies is deceptively good. It's making them get stuck in place and take the Tesla coil damage for longer. Yeah, it's been a little bit since I've done one of those. Here's just a bunch of things that I'm trying for the first time. But I'm looking forward to getting back to building my little Dondoko Island on Friday, or maybe even a daytime stream tomorrow. We'll see how it goes. But it's nice every now and then to do one of these. Here's a bunch of stuff I want to give a go or want to show off kind of streams. I've got to be in the right ADHD of it all, of the brain, to be in a, yeah, let's jump between things kind of night. Okay, let's break that second egg open any moment now. Here it is. Oh yeah, that's the slowdown effect Tesla coil upgrade is one I need to do again in future. That one is really nice. Okay, let's clear this out so we can get our supply drop. Ooh, standing still increases my fire rate and reload speed. Very good for my particular build. I need some health, ideally, if I can find some. I need to find the third small egg. Yeah, so if I stand still, this should buff up real good. Grab a bunch of XP. Is this the big egg or is this one of the smalls? Oh, that's the big egg. I need to find the other small egg quickly. Check the minimap. If I don't find it soon, that okay, yeah, the big egg, the third small egg hatched by itself because I didn't find it fast enough. That's on me. Not the worst thing that could happen, but means I didn't get a jump start on damaging it. But it is dead. Can I find any health or... It's calling to me. Let's get one extra flamethrower. Cool, let's go crack the big egg. And deal with the thing it will unleash that is a bit of a nightmare to fight. Let's fight a dreadnought. This thing will deal massive damage if it can reach me, and every now and then it'll do a little animation and then try and leap at me. So I have to do a right angle to like avoid where it's going to land when it leaps. So I've got to sort of make sure I have room to do a 90 degree turn at all times. Oh, and I got stuck on a rock and it got me. Yeah, the dreadnoughts are, they don't fuck around. You have to you have to play very effective keep away. But that's Deep Rock Galactic Survivors, and then you use all those materials down the bottom of the screen. Those are things you mine in the level to buy your between round upgrade. So let's increase my max health. Why not? Yeah, like I fucked up there. That was my fault, but. Yeah, the Dreadnought don't fuck around. But yeah, I really recommend this. If you are someone who likes a Survivors type game, it is a single analog stick and occasionally button to confirm. I would say I really like that each of these characters feels distinct, but also their starting weapon / starting ability like distinctly changes them as well. 5 difficulty modes per environment of the 3 current maps. There is a lot to see in here. Cool. Thank you very much, everyone, for watching. I hope you've enjoyed. I will be back with some more Dondoko Island, Animal Crossing, Like a Dragon streaming soon. Have a good rest of your night.